Alright, this section deals with dividing polynomials and also using the remainder and factor theorems. And in this section, we're going to be using long division to divide polynomials, also using synthetic division to divide polynomials, and also we're going to evaluate a polynomial using the remainder theorem and use the factor theorem to solve a polynomial equation. Okay, in long division, we use the repetitive procedure for polynomials, polynomial long division. The first thing we do is divide, then multiply, subtract, then bring down the next term. You have to think of this if you remember back in elementary school when you were doing something like this. Let's say 14 divided into, let's say, 7/48. Okay, the way you'll have to do that is you have to divide and see how many times 14 would go into 74. Because we know 14 can't go into 7, but 14 can go into 74, we'll say 5 times. And then you have to do the second step, which is multiply, which is 5 times 14, that's 70. And then subtract 70 from 74, that will give you the 4. Bring down the next number, which is 8. And then divide 14 into 48, which will go 3 times. And then 3 times 14 will give you 42. Then subtract 42 from 48, and you'll get 6. And we know 14 can't go into 6, so that means that your 6 will be your remainder. So your final answer there will be 53, remainder 6. That idea of using long division with whole numbers is the same procedure that you'll be using with polynomials when you use long division. And here's an example of just that. Let's say we have this particular problem. We want to divide x squared plus 14x plus 45 by x plus 9. Okay, now I'm going to write this a little bit different from what I have on the sheet of paper. And usually we will write it like this. You have the x plus 9, which is your divisor, and then your dividend is going to be x squared plus 14x plus 5. Alright, now the way we're going to do that is, now you're going to have to follow along with me. You have to take the first term of your dividend, which is x squared, divide that by the first term of your divisor, which is x. So you have x squared divided by x. That's going to give you the x. That x is going to go up here on top. And then you're going to multiply that x that you place here on top times the divisor. So here you're going to have x times x plus 9. And x times x is x squared. And x times 9, that's plus 9x. So that x squared plus 9x goes here. Now the next step is to subtract. And when we subtract, we change the sign of each and every term to the opposite. So that x squared becomes negative, the 9x becomes negative. Okay, and then we combine like terms here. These x squares are going to be gone. You're going to have 14x plus negative 9x, which will be 5x, plus 5. Now I think I copied that problem wrong. This would be 45. Okay, so we bring down the next term, which is 45. So you have 5x plus 45. Okay, now we take the first term, which is 5x, divide that by the first term of your divisor, which is 5. So you got 5x divided by 5, which is, I'm sorry, 5x divided by x. That's the first term of this expression divided by the first term of your divisor. So this is going to be 5x divided by x, which will give you 5. Okay, and that 5 is a plus 5, so that plus 5 goes up here. And then you'll do 5 times x plus 9. Well, 5 times x, that's 5x. And 5 times 9, that's plus 45. So 5x plus 45 goes here. And then we subtract by changing the sign of each and every term and adding. Now notice that the 5x's are gone and the 45's are gone. You're left with 0. So here the remainder is 0, so that means that x plus 5 is the other factor for x squared plus 14x plus 45. Okay, so that's how we use long division in order to divide polynomials. Okay, now, if I can get to this other sheet of paper. The division algorithm is this. Your f of x, which is your dividend, that's going to be equal to d of x, which is your divisor, multiplied by q of x, that's the quotient, plus r of x, which is your remainder. Okay, that's basically what the division algorithm is. Okay. Now let's say we have this particular problem. Divide 7 minus 11x minus 3x squared plus 2x cubed by x minus 3. And we want to express the result in the form of a quotient plus the remainder divided by the divisor. Okay, now, I'm going to rewrite this a little bit differently because with this one, I'm going to put this in descending powers, which means the 2x cubed will go first, and then minus 3x squared will be second, then minus 11x plus 7. And I'm going to write this as a traditional division problem like I have here. Okay. Now, just like I did in that last problem, which I'm going to try to do a little bit better, the first term of the dividend will be divided by the first term of your divisor. So here, the 2x cubed, which is the first term of your dividend, divided by the divisor, which is x. First term of your divisor, which is x. So 2x cubed divided by x will be 2x squared. And that 2x squared will go above that minus 3x squared. And then we multiply 2x squared times x minus 3. So I'm going to write this off to the side. So here, 2x squared divided by x, that's 2x cubed. 2x squared divided by, times minus 3 will be a minus 6x squared. Here I'm using a distributive property. So 2x squared times x is this. 2x squared times minus 3 is minus 6x squared. This part goes underneath here. So I'm going to bring right down the 2x cubed minus 6x squared. And then we're going to subtract. When we subtract, we change the sign to the opposite for each term. This will be negative. This was minus 6x, so this was minus 6x squared. That's going to change to a plus 6x squared. And then we're going to add the two together. These 2x cubes will be gone. So now you're left with negative 3x squared plus 6x squared. That's going to be a positive 3x squared. And then you bring down the minus 11x. And then we repeat the division process here. We take the first term of this expression, 3x squared, divide that by the first term of the divisor, which is x. So 3x squared divided by x is 3x. And it's a plus 3x, so that plus 3x goes up here. And now we're going to take that 3x and multiply by the divisor. So it'll be 3x times x minus 3, which will be, in this case, 3x squared minus 9x. Here I'm using a distributive property. So that 3x squared minus 9x goes here. And then we're going to subtract by changing the sign to the opposite. This will be negative, and that 9x will become minus 9x becomes plus 9x. So the 3x squares are going to cancel. Here, negative 11x plus 9x will be negative 2x. And then we bring down the next term, which is plus 7. And then finally, you'll do negative 2x, which is the first term of that expression, divided by the first term of your divisor. That's going to be x. So negative 2x divided by x, that's going to be a minus 2. And then we'll put the minus 2 up here. So now you got minus 2 times x minus 3, which would give you negative 2x plus 6. So that negative 2x plus 6 will go here. Now we subtract by changing the sign to the opposite, so that negative 2x becomes a plus, that plus 6 becomes minus 6. So the 2x's will give you 0, they're going to be gone. 7 minus 6 would be 1. And that completes the long division process here. So here you have the remainder of 1, so now you can have this as that answer as 2x squared plus 3x minus 2. Now your remainder is going to be 1 over the divisor of x minus 3. So that's how you'll write that as a quotient plus your remainder. The remainder is always going to be that expression over your divisor. Okay. And if you look at the answer that I have here, at the bottom, you know, I've already worked it out, you can see there's the quotient plus your remainder. Now, if a power of x is missing in either the dividend or the divisor, you want to add that power of x with a coefficient of 0, and then divide. This way, like terms will be aligned as you carry out the long division. So if you're missing, let's say, an x squared term, you need to compensate for that by putting a 0 x squared. Or if an x term is missing, you have to compensate for that by putting 0 x. And in this particular problem, we have 2x to the 4th plus 3x cubed minus 7x minus 10. And we want to divide that by x squared minus 2x. Notice in the dividend, which is right here, we got x to the 4th, we got x to the 3rd. We're missing an x squared term because we're going from x to the 3rd down to an x term. So an x squared term is missing. So when I rewrite this division problem, I'm going to put 0x squared in it. So we got 2x to the 4th plus 3x cubed plus 0x squared minus 7x minus 10. Okay. Just want to make sure I'm copying this thing correctly. So as you can see here, I'm putting 0x squared there. That way, it'll be easier for me to align the terms. So here, any missing powers of x that's missing, you have to put 0 for that particular power. Now we start the long division process here. The first term of the dividend is divided by the first term of the divisor. You got 2x to the 4th. That's the first term of the dividend divided by the first term of your divisor. That's x squared. So 2x to the 4th divided by x squared will be 2x squared. And that 2x squared is going to go above the 0x squared, as you can see, aligning the x squared terms. And then you'll do 2x squared times your divisor of x squared minus 2x. So here, I do this off to the side, 2x squared times x squared minus 2x. This will give me 2x to the 4th minus 4x cubed. And that 2x to the 4th minus 4x cubed will go here. And then we subtract. We change the sign of each and every term to to the opposite, and then add. So 2x to the fourth, that's gone. 3x to the third plus 4x to the third, that's 7x to the third. Then I'm going to bring down that plus 0x squared. Okay, we bring down the next term and then do the synthetic division, the division process again. The first term of this expression is 7x cubed. Divide that by the first term of your divisor, that's x squared. So 7x cubed divided by x squared, that's going to be 7x. And it's a plus 7x, so that plus 7x goes up here. And then we're going to multiply that 7x times x squared minus 2x. Using the distributive property here, we're going to have 7x times x squared, that's 7x cubed. Then 7x times minus 2x will be a minus 14x squared. That goes down here. 7x squared, 7x cubed, minus 14x squared. And then we subtract by changing the sign of each and every term to the opposite. That 7x cubed becomes negative, and then minus 14x squared becomes plus. So the 7x cubes, they're gone. 0x squared and 14x squared will be 14x squared. Then bring down minus 7x. And then we'll start again with 14x squared divided by x squared. That's the first term of this expression, but divided by the first term of your divisor. So 14x squared divided by x squared will be 14. And it's a plus 14, so that plus 14 goes here. And then you're going to do 14 times x squared minus 2x, which is your divisor. So 14 times x squared will be 14x squared minus 14 times 2x, that's going to give me 28x. So here we got 14x squared minus 28x. And then we subtract by changing the sign of each and every term to the opposite and add. So now the 14x squares, they're gone. Minus 7x plus 28x is going to be 21x. Then you bring down the last term, which is a minus 10. Now notice that the exponent in 21x is less than the highest exponent in my divisor. So this will be as far as I can go with that problem. Okay, so 21x minus 10 represents the remainder. Okay, so my quotient and remainder will be 2x squared plus 7x plus 14, and then plus 21x minus 10 over the divisor of x squared minus 2x. Okay, so this is how we use long division in order to divide polynomials. Fortunately, there is an easier way to divide polynomials, and that is by the use of synthetic division. Now here we can use synthetic division to divide polynomials if the divisor is of the form x minus c. Now that's the only restriction. X minus c is the form that your divisor must be in. Now this method provides a quotient that's more quickly than you would if you were to do this long division. And this is the procedure to do this. This is over two sheets, so follow along. If we want to divide a polynomial by x minus c, we want to arrange the polynomial in descending powers with a zero coefficient for any missing terms. Then number two, you're going to write c for the divisor x minus c. To the right, write the coefficients of the dividend. And then number three, write the leading coefficient of the dividend on the bottom row. Then number four, you're going to multiply c times the value just written on the bottom row, and then you're going to write that product on the next column in the second row. And then you're going to add those values in that column, writing that sum in the bottom row. And then you're going to repeat the series of multiplications and additions until all the columns are filled. And then the seventh step would be to use the numbers in the last row to write the quotient plus the remainder above the divisor. The degree of the first term of the quotient is 1 degree less than the degree of the first term of the dividend. And the final value in that row is going to be the remainder. That's going to be very important because the quotient is always going to be one exponent less than the highest exponent of your dividend. And the last number in the last row is always your remainder. So let's see how this procedure is going to be done with this particular problem. Let's say we want to use synthetic division to divide 5x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x plus 11 by x minus 2. And we're going to use synthetic division here in this case. So I'm going to set this up as a division problem. The x minus 2 is already in the form x minus c. Now it's a minus 2, so that means we have to use a positive 2. Now had that been x plus 2, then this 2 would have been negative. And then we're going to write down our the coefficients for our dividend. Notice that there are no missing terms. We have x cubed, x squared, then x, and then the constant. So we write down their coefficients. Let's see. For x cubed is 5. For x squared is negative 6. For 3x is 3. And then 11. All right. And here we begin our synthetic division. We bring down the first term in the bottom row. That's the leading coefficient, which is the 5. So the first number here in our dividend, we bring that down in the bottom row. And then we start multiplying that number that we just brought down times the divisor. So here we'll do 5 times 2, which is 10. Now the 10 is going to go underneath the negative 6. Not underneath the 5, it goes underneath the 6. Okay? We place that number underneath the second column and then add those two numbers together. Negative 6 plus 10, that's going to give me 4. And we keep repeating this process until all the columns are filled. So here we do 4 times 2, which is 8. That goes underneath the 3. Then add 3 and 8 together, you're going to get 11. And then we'll finally do 11 times 2. That's going to give us 22. And then 11 plus 22 is 33. Okay, so here all the columns are filled. Now, that bottom row represents the quotient and the remainder. Now, the last number in the last row is the remainder. These other numbers represent the quotient. Now, the quotient is always one exponent less than the highest exponent in our dividend. We began that problem with 5x cubed. So the quotient will begin as 5x squared. It's always one exponent less than that. If it was 5x cubed in the dividend, then we decrease that by 1. So it'll be 5x squared. And then these others will be the coefficients of the powers of exponents with decreasing powers. So we start off with 5x squared, then the 4 will become the coefficient of x, then plus 11. Plus this remainder, which is 33, that's going to be written over the divisor of x minus 2. So the final answer there in this case will be 5x squared plus 4x plus 11 plus 33 divided over x minus 2. All right, let's look at another synthetic division problem. Now notice we got x cubed minus 7x minus 6. And we want to divide that by x plus 2. Now this one, we got x cubed, but we're missing an x squared. So we got to have a 0 for the x squared. And then the coefficient of x and then our constant. And notice we got x plus 2, so in this case, we're going to use negative 2. And in this case here, we got the x cubed. Its coefficient is 1. We're missing an x squared term, so we need to put a 0 here. We got the coefficient of x, that's negative 7. And our constant is negative 6. So this is how we set up that particular problem. And here's we're going to set up. Here's how we're going to do the synthetic division. The leading coefficient is 1, so we bring that down in the bottom row. And then we start the multiplications and addition process. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. So 0 and negative 2 added together, you'll get negative 2. And then negative 2 times negative 2 will be positive 4. Negative 7 plus 4, that's negative 3. And then negative 3 times negative 2 is 6. Negative 6 plus 6 is 0. So that's the synthetic division process here. Now, to identify the quotient and the remainder, the last number in the last row is the remainder. And the remainder is 0, so we don't need to write that as 0 over x plus 2. However, this part represents the quotient. That quotient is one exponent less than the highest exponent. In our dividend, we started off as x to the third, so this 1 becomes the coefficient of x squared. And then minus 2, which will be your coefficient of x, minus 3. And x squared minus 2x minus 3 will be the final answer there. Since the remainder is 0, we don't need to write that as plus 0 over x plus 2. This will do just fine. Okay, the next thing we'll look at is the remainder theorem. Here's synthetic division is also used in the remainder theorem. If the polynomial f of x is divided by x minus c, then the remainder is f of c. Okay, so when you use the synthetic division process, whatever the remainder is, that's going to be the value of that particular function for that particular function at that particular value, which is in this case c. And to see how this works, let's look at an example of how we can use the remainder theorem. Here you're given the function f of x is equal to 3x cubed plus 4x squared minus 5x plus 3. And here we want to use that remainder theorem to find f of negative 4. Okay, so we're finding what f of negative 4 is using the remainder theorem and also using the concept of synthetic division. We're evaluating f of negative 4, so that negative 4 would be your divisor. Okay, now let's look at our f of x function. There are no missing terms. We got x to the third, then x squared, and then x, and then a constant. So here, we can write down the numerical coefficients of 3, 4, negative 5, and 3. And then we go ahead and use the synthetic division process. The first term, which is our leading coefficient, we bring that down in the bottom row. And then we do 3 times negative 4, that's negative 12. Then 4 plus negative 12 is negative 8. And then we do negative 8 times negative 4, that's going to give us 32. Negative 5 plus 32, that's going to give us positive 27. And then 27 times negative 4, which will be a negative 108. And then 3 plus negative 108 is negative 105. So that negative 105 is your remainder. Not only that, that negative 105, of course, your remainder is always going to be the value of that particular function when x is negative 4. So we can conclude that f of negative 4 is equal to negative 105. Using this is much easier than just replacing the x with negative 4 and hoping that you'll get the correct answer of negative 105. When you finish working it out. Okay. All right, the next thing we'll look at is the factor theorem. And here we're letting f of x be a polynomial. And if f of c is equal to 0, then x minus c will be a factor of f of x. And conversely, if x minus c is a factor of f of x, then that means that f of c then will be equal to 0. So in this case, let's see how we can use the factor theorem to solve this particular equation. Let's say we want to solve this equation, solve the equation 15x to the third plus 14x squared minus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. And we're told that negative 1 is a 0 of that particular function. F of x is equal to 15x cubed plus 14x squared minus 3x minus 2. So we know that negative 1 is a 0 of this particular function. Now we want to solve this. Okay? We can use the synthetic division. Since we know negative 1 is a 0 of this function, let's find out what the other polynomial is going to be. Okay, so in this case here, negative 1 will be my divisor. Notice that there are no missing terms here, so we'll use their coefficients. For x cubed is 15, for x squared is 14, for x is minus 3, and for the constant is negative 2. And here we go ahead and use the synthetic division process. We bring down the 15 in the bottom row and do 15 times negative 1, that's negative 15. Then 14 plus negative 15 is negative 1. And then we'll do negative 1 times negative 1, that's 1. Negative 3 plus 1, that will be negative 2. Then negative 2 times negative 1 will be 2. And then negative 2 plus 2 is 0. Here we got a remainder of 0, so that means this part is going to be the other factor. Okay? Since negative 1 is a 0, that means that one of the factors had to be x plus 1. Okay? This is going to be the other factor. And it's 1 degree less, one exponent less than the highest exponent here. If that's 15x to the third, then that means that this will have to be 15x squared. And then minus x minus 2 equal to 0. And then that 15x squared minus x minus 2, we can factor that into two binomials. Let's see, 15x squared, I'm going to use 3x and 5x. And then for 2, let's see. If I put minus 2 here and a plus 1 here, that will mean that 3x and minus 2, that would be minus 6x, plus this inner term, which is 5x, minus 6x plus 5x, that will give me the minus x that I need. So my other two factors will be 3x plus 1 times 5x minus 2 equal to 0. And then we set each binomial factor equal to 0. So in this case here, we'll set x plus 1 equal to 0. And then 3x plus 1 equal to 0. 5x minus 2 equal to 0. Well, for x plus 1 is equal to 0, we know that x is equal to negative 1. We know that negative 1 had to be a 0 of this particular polynomial function. For 3x plus 1 is equal to 0, subtract 1, you're going to get 3x is equal to negative 1. Divide by 3, you'll get x is equal to negative 1/3. And then for 5x minus 2 is equal to 0, add 2, you're going to get 5x is equal to 2. Divide by 5, x is equal to 2/5. Okay, so the solution set would be, of course, negative 1 that was given to us as a 0. The other two zeros are negative 1/3 and 2/5. Okay. So that's how we use the factor theorem to find, to solve a polynomial equation, or to find the zeros of any polynomial function. And that will conclude this particular section on dividing polynomials and also using the remainder theorem and the factor theorem.